Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thrilled to be here to talk about the new era of transparent orchestration, which is upon us. And it's going to give all of us here in cybersecurity the visibility to act, which is something that we're lacking today. And very pertinent, the earlier conversation about GDPR and the fines and all of that that are expected. However, before we go, let's start. The story starts with my daughter. So I have a 7-year-old daughter, and she is into My Little Pony. I don't know, I don't get it, but you know, apparently 7-year-old girls are into My Little Pony. So she waits for me to come home and wants me to play it for her. So I kind of recorded the steps that I go through to get to that point where I can actually play it for her. So I made a little video about that. So, you know, I have to first go get the remote. Of course, turn the TV on. It's a smart TV, so it has a home button, which has the apps. So I need to go find the right app to play. So I got the Netflix. Once you go in there, you have to search for the show on this amazingly user-friendly keyboard that we all love to use. I don't know why they can't change it, but I start looking for my, and then my Babysitter's a Vampire shows up, which is scary. But I wanted My Little Pony, so find the show. She's very particular about the episode, the season, the specific episode that she wants to watch. So finally get to that point, play it, and then I'm hoping that she is happy. But she's not, okay? So as you saw, it's modern technology. You had a smart TV, you have all these things, but it was multiple different steps that were required to get to that point so that she could actually watch it. So she thinks this guy's too slow. I need to orchestrate him out of the equation so I can get to what I need to fast. So this is what she has done, figured out how to get to what she wants without needing me in the equation. Of course, she needs me to buy the stuff, but after that, she's figured it out.
Okay, Google, play My Little Pony from Netflix on Living Room.
All right, My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic from Netflix, playing on Living Room.
So there you go. The TV turns on, pulls up the right episode, and it starts playing, right? So how cool is that? You have multiple vendors, hardware from different vendors, the speakers from Google, the TVs from LG, the software app is from Netflix, the content is, you know, from Hollywood or whoever, but she's able to get to what she wants with just a single voice command saying, play this, and she gets that. She gets that, you know, gets to the point that she needs to in just one single voice command. That's how, in the consumer world, what's happening in the consumer world, how integrated systems, how vendors are working together to really come up with ways that make our life at home easy. Now let's turn to our world. What a mess we have to deal with. We got all kinds of vendors, all kinds of hardware, all kinds of software. You got the cloud. Even there, you have like 3 clouds and 7 soon. So even there, you don't have a uniform way of doing anything. You have systems that have been put together over a period of time, which means that they have different architecture. So, you know, the architecture of the AIX machine and the Oracle database and all of that is very different than the architecture of the cloud today. but we kind of tried to put all of that together to make those systems work. It just keeps, it's incremental. It gets added on. You come up with a new app, you add it to your existing set of apps and try to make it work. So which means that with the different architecture, these systems don't really talk to each other. Sounds familiar in our world? It's the IT team and the security team. Arch nemesis, don't want to talk to each other, don't want anything to do with each other. IT goes out, you know, they develop their app, they don't care about security, they package it, throw it over the fence, and now it's security's problem. If there's a breach because of a vulnerability in the code, it's security's fault. How is that our fault? We didn't even write the code. But hey, you know. So then, of course, security team, they are their own silo. So they take all these different IT systems that are thrown at them, and then they buy their own IT systems on top of that to secure these IT systems. They don't want to talk to the IT guys because they always give code with vulnerabilities. And but you know, if we talk to them and give them our tools, and if the code actually has no vulnerabilities, then maybe we don't have a job, right? So whatever the reason, that's how security guys are thinking about that. So what we have today in our IT systems is a whole bunch of different systems that get thrown out in the infrastructure, and then security goes and buys their tools and puts them around that infrastructure so that you know you cannot breach them. A whole bunch of different firewalls and all kinds of systems, so hopefully you can stop someone from coming in and create this bolted on security. It's after the fact bolted on security, right? Anybody who has not experienced this in their organization may be at the wrong conference right now. This is the reality that we deal with all the time. And so, what is the cost of all of this? I don't even venture to try to put any number on it because we deal with this every day. Security goes about and buys all kinds of different solutions. Then they have to buy the hardware to deploy those solutions. Then they have to go and buy the software on those solutions. They have to hire developers to try to make those solutions work with each other. They have to hire experts for each of those systems so they can manage those. And you know, in security, even if you have the money, the people don't exist. You can't get the people who can actually help you do this. So the cost of this is tremendous right now. So we do have an opportunity. This is what I want to talk about. That the good news is that we have a once-in-a-lifetime unique opportunity today that has not existed in the long 40, 50, 60 years of IT development that we have done, where, as I gave that example earlier, everything has been incrementally added. So we have the opportunity to reboot the way we think about security and IT today. And the way we can do that is enter the hero, which is digital transformation. So a lot of organizations today are going through this digital transformation exercise to take all of their existing systems and move them to modern technology into the cloud, containers, all kinds of different modern environment. But that's not really, it's not so much that they're taking an existing system and just pushing it to the cloud. It is the fact that right now, a lot of organizations are going back to the drawing board and completely redesigning their application architecture so that they can natively move these applications into the cloud. And this is why this is a unique opportunity, because so far we've always done IT incrementally. And what is happening today that, and this was the panel earlier, there's a lot of talk about GDPR this, GDPR that, it's bad, it's scary, and all of that, but organizations are realizing that the cost of securing their existing infrastructure by bolting on all of that security after the fact is so high that it is actually cheaper to go back and redesign those applications and put them into the new infrastructure where all of them can be instrumented the right way And that's really what the opportunity we have today, to actually build in this infrastructure, the security into the infrastructure, and not have it bolted on as has been done for such a long time. So we have the opportunity as IT is going about designing and redesigning and re-architecting those applications to try to get security at the table. So the DevOps, DevSecOps, it's not just a phrase that looks good on our resume to get a better job, right? It's actually real. This is the big change that is happening right now, that development, operations, security people are actually working together to ensure that the re-architected apps are being done in a way that they are elastic, they are easy to deploy, they are self-scaling. And the big part of that is that security is built in. We can eliminate a lot of the security issues in the development cycle upfront before even that application goes to production. And after that, we need to have ensure that we instrument those applications upfront so that all the information we require to manage and monitor those apps when they are in production is actually already built in to create this integrated application framework and integrated platform where we can make that security something that is not a hindrance to the end users who are using this. So you have your endpoints, you have your security. Just take an example of, you know, when I talk about bolted on security, might seem a little abstract, but take your servers today. You have servers out in production, and you have like 8, 9, 10 different agents on them. And each of the agents is looking at what? The exact same stuff. They're looking at the same network connection. They're looking at the same file change, looking at the same process change. They're looking at the same memory utilization, just interpreting things differently because they were not built in. So if we need, if this is a requirement that for us to have security and monitor the behavior of the application, we need to have it instrumented, then this is the time to make sure that we collect all of that data once, whatever we need, and then we can analyze it in different ways after the fact and not try to get 10, 15, 20 different, you know, unicorn agents out there to, you know, claim that they will get the security, which we don't get today. So this is not just abstract. So the good news is that with the cloud providers like Amazon, Azure, this phenomena is already happening right now. So I put together a little video that kind of shows today how, for example, in the Azure Security Center, this is where all of the IT infrastructure is visible in one place, which is the big change. We have not had the visibility in the infrastructure in the past, but it will pop up the recommendations, for example, that you need on its own to say, these virtual machines are missing vulnerability assessment. Click and install vulnerability assessment on them. That's it. One click. The end user does not know how it is done. It is already instrumented in the back end. Not only that, once it has been done, they come back in a few hours. Within that same console where they used to manage the IT infrastructure, they see all of the findings. They see all of the issues that their application has without having to go to 10 different consoles from different providers. Not only can they see what is wrong, the cool part about that is within that same Azure Security Center console, they can write their remediation rules without having to buy another 4 products to try to make all of that work. It's simple. If there is a vulnerability on a machine that has an external facing IP and is exploitable, then create a security rule which will block that particular port for that particular virtual machine and then send a message to Slack. All of that within the same console without ever having to leave that. Think of how this kind of transparent orchestration can really make our life significantly easier if we take the effort up front to really instrument and leverage what is going on in this new phenomena of IT, digital transformation, and building things in, where all of this is something that the end user never has to worry about. How do I get the security? I don't need to be a PhD in trying to install a particular application for security. I need security on my infrastructure. I just check a box, and it's there. There's 3 distinct types of orchestration that we saw in that particular video. The first one is orchestration at deployment, is that you need security, you just say, yes, I need security. I don't need to have to be a PhD in installing each individual security application. It's already done. Second is the monitoring aspect of it, the orchestration of monitoring. You don't have to go and hire a whole bunch of programmers using lots of API calls, putting together a third system where you can collect all of these logs and have its own different console. Whatever you need from a monitoring perspective is available right there. That's another orchestration. And all of this is leading towards the third orchestration, which is that response, which is the visibility to act, which is if I have all of that visibility in that same console, if I'm able to quickly just turn it on, see what's coming up, now I can act in a much better way. That's the response. So these new systems, cloud, containers, have all of these advantages where if you instrument them, but you have to not just go and take the old way of doing things and implement in the cloud. You have to really think through and instrument them upfront, and you're going to get a lot of those benefits. It's actually going to make you save you a lot of money. It's actually going to make you act really secure, because for the first time, you go into that console, you see every single virtual machine you have, what's the status of each of those virtual machines, and probably make you a hero with the board, because you are the one who kind of brought that in. So that's an additional benefit. And this is just the start. There's so many advantages to moving towards these solutions beyond just the simple things of like, OK, I'm going to get better security. Going back to that first video that I showed between the multiple steps versus, you know, my seven-year-old, like drawing inspiration from my seven-year-old, what she was able to do, we kind of to show how if you instrument things upfront and leverage these systems, what kind of capabilities security can get. We put together a concept application that highlights what capabilities we can get in the very near future. OK, Google, talk to Qualys Cloud Support.
All right, getting the test version of Qualys Cloud Support. Hello, how can Qualys help you?
How many cloud accounts do I have?
You have 15 accounts in Oz, 5 accounts in Azure, and 1 account in Google Cloud.
How many resources do I have in AWS?
There are a total of 16,823 resources in your Oz accounts.
What is the current security assessment for the marketing production account?
There are 5 control failures and 3 are new.
What are the 3 new failures?
There are 12 S3 buckets which have public access enabled. 1 security group allows unrestricted ingress access to port 22. 5 instances with public IP have exploitable vulnerabilities.
Post the control failures to SOC Slack channel.
Control failures posted to SOC Slack channel.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
And they're so polite compared to our security guys. So this is real, right? I mean, these technologies today exist. And with the new software as a service, security as a service, building things in instrumentation, we can really get to this point very quickly. And that's the direction that we are going. So this transparent orchestration is really, you know, we started off by looking at the current way we are doing incrementally developed IT systems, trying to slap on, bolt on security solutions after the fact that don't really work, don't really give us the visibility. But if we take that additional step, think through, ride on the current bus where boards are actually giving IT teams a lot of money to rewrite their applications, and make sure that you can actually, I know it's hard, but make sure you can make friendship with the IT guys, then we can get a better, much better security, eliminate those hundreds of agents, get back to having instrumentation built in right from the beginning, and essentially provide and give us that visibility that we are lacking And this is now, I believe, the time for us to act. Thank you very much.